right, I'm just getting up. It is, well, actually, I've been up like half an hour. It's 8 a.m. right now. So I'm feeling a little bit sick. You know, you can hear my voice back. I'm feeling my chest a bit. But, you know, it is what it is. I'm here. I'm still happy. I'm alive. So, you know, nothing I can really complain about. Another day up is another day to be thankful for.
I want to take this time to stand there and look you in the face and let's kick it about being.
All right, so I'm on my way out to the cafe. This is where I get picked up. So, cafe, and then we out to the retreat. All right, so I just reached the cafe. We are here. This is the view. Emirates, what's up? Laura, Raleigh, what's going on, guys? We are doing first ceremony of ayahuasca tonight.
So we're making our way out to the jungle. Get to choose being in the back of the truck or the front of the truck. Let's see how this ride goes. I'm jumping in the back. I think it's gonna be a bumpy ride. Let's go. But before the jungle, we gotta make a quick pit stop to the supermercado. We gotta get some groceries. We gotta get some toiletries because we are gonna be out in the jungle. It's gonna be real life out there. So, you know, we gotta get everything ahead of time because it is a long ride out there.
It's not good enough for me since I've been with you. Ooh.
First time, it was about healing, you know.
Yeah.
I go to myself on my jeans when I was very unconscious, you know.
Yeah.
So I it was like a process to forget myself about my inconscience when I was in.
Yes.
Okay? And the second time was amazing because I arrived in, okay? So I traveled out of my body, you know?
Yeah.
I see everything outside of my body. And then I come to myself.
Hey, this is super cool with all the motorbikes and stuff. Oh man. Alright, so your reason for what's your reason for trying out ayahuasca?
So I've had quite a few psychedelic experiences, both with like acid and mushrooms. And they've all been just fantastic. And I had a friend of mine that came to do this particular ayahuasca retreat in May, she had just a phenomenal experience. So after her like sitting down and telling me her story, like, I don't know, it's like her whole energy was just so different and it was so genuine and like incredible. I was convinced that I had to come and do it.
How long is the drive to the...
From Lamas, we're going to be taking about 40 minutes on a dirt road.
All right, and we've reached first day at the retreat.
Yes.
And we got our huts ready, we got our place ready, and it is ayahuasca ceremony tonight. We dive it in the deep end on day one.
His head just came out. Do you see it?
Oh shit!
How do?
Oh shit! In the hut, you guys.
It says it's not venomous.
It's not? Okay, I was sure.
Good to know. That is great.
Safe.
Ceremony starting at 4 p.m. We initiate a time of
there's an access to the river right here. It's not the best swimming spot, but you feel like connecting to the waters or something like that.
I know everybody I go like we, still we Irie, come in all over life.
River, we gotta get in a, what's it called again? What kind of shower? A plant shower, something like that. Yes, it's gonna be good. We're not showering together, but.
We do it for the love, we not do it for the lights.
Do it for the love, we not do it for the lights.
Do it for the love, we not do it for the lights.
Or he's gonna offer you a bucket full of water for the plants to pour out to your head. And before you do that, what you need to do is go inside, close your eyes, and offer a prayer with the plant. That's with the plant. And ask the plant for something in your life. You can, you know, it could be an intention or maybe something you're asking for to bring into your life. Ask the plant for that help. And then
first ayahuasca ceremony. Staying in the jungle and going into my ayahuasca ceremony, my first one. I would have never thought that I'd be doing this, but here I am. I'm happy to be here.
You know, it was a tough experience.
My ayahuasca experience was quite the experience. It started at 7 p.m. pitch darkness when we made our way down to the ceremony area. Only the moonlight and the stars guided our way, really. When we got in there, it was pure silence. We all sat in a circle and Scott lit a substance and let burn while he went over the ceremony rules. As the ceremony rules were done, the ayahuasca was ready. The shaman had it, so we had to go over to the shaman, greet him, get our one shot of ayahuasca, knock that shot back, and knew it was about a 30-minute wait time. That 30-minute wait time probably felt like 15. When that 15-minute mark hit, I could feel it happening. Started off like cobwebs, black and gray. It was like, oh yeah, now it's happening. With my eyes closed, those gray and blacks turned into vivid, crazy colors and shapes like cubes of white and green that immediately turned into other colors and other shapes of forms, constantly changing and moving. It was like traveling through a vortex or a computer screen with a bit of weird animations to do it. At times, those shapes would produce animals' eyes or mouths. I'm sure I saw a cubed version of Cat in the Hat that quickly changed into another shape or formation. It was like passing by a video game. All cubes and shapes forming into lions and cats and dragons of all styles and all colors. It was so crazy that it was hard to keep track and explain what's going on. I felt like my trip came in stages and I considered this stage one. Throughout the train ride of crazy color shapes, formation, characters, I kept saying to myself, this is crazy, what the fuck is going on? I felt like it went on forever. And as time gradually grew, it started to become more and more intense. It started to get difficult. My trip was shifting from an easy to hard experience. From starting a roller coaster ride to taking the first plunge. In my mind, I got to the point like, okay, I'm ready to pack it in. The different shapes and scenarios and colors switching from one thing to the next just wouldn't stop coming. It was like I shifted in the second gear. In second gear, it was like stage two. Those shapes started to take forms. I'm 100% sure I saw Mario Kart during my trip. Mario was there, Bowser was there. It was like my subconscious was pulling memories. I used to love Mario Kart, it's one of the greatest games of all time. The next character I saw was Joe Rogan. Why Joe Rogan? Because I watched a ton of Joe Rogan stuff on ayahuasca. He has a clip in black and white where he's speaking about DMT, aka psychedelics. That clip was clear as day in my trip. And a few other flashes from his podcast, example, the interview with Dorian Yates. That was also part of my trip. Up next, my trip shifted into more people. During this state of my trip, I was fighting purging on and off, which would shift me in and out of the trip and back into my trip. My mind played out quite a few different scenarios that I knew I would enjoy. I learned things and came to the realization that it was an addiction. Coming to this realization, my trip took me into a bunker where my addiction lay in a bottle shaped like a long green tube, and inside it was the addiction as a physical element shaped like a muscle tendon. I picked up the tube, put it in a crushing machine. The machine crushed it a few times and I threw it in the furnace. The bunker of beliefs, emotions and behaviors. In this bunker in long green tubes lay my behaviors and emotions and beliefs, the negative ones. I took each and every single tube and cut the lifeline connected to me. Once I cut each and every one of them, I started the same process by throwing them in the crushing machine, which is like a machine they use to crush cars. That completely crushed them. I learned that certain negative behaviors do not solve things, along with other negative emotions and actions. I threw away all of my old beliefs, my old negative beliefs, and got them right into the crusher and then into the furnace. I'm happy to have a new belief system. The purge is like ridding your body of all negatives. At this moment, I felt like I'm roughly 2 hours in. Quite honestly, I have no clue how long it's been. The entire time I've been resisting the urge and fighting the urge to purge. Sometimes it hit me in my stomach and I feel like I gotta go to the bathroom. Sometimes I feel like I need to vomit. At the time, I heard no one else purge, so I didn't want to be the first one to purge, as I'm not a discreet vomiter. And I didn't want to disturb anybody else's trip or peace. I noticed once or twice when I opened my eyes that people were having a tough time. They were getting up and they were stepping out. So I decided to step out myself. I kept saying to myself, I don't need a purge, I can handle it. Those are just words of encouragement to myself, really, because when some purges hit my stomach, it was discomforting to say the least. After what seemed like an hour, which probably wasn't, I said, fuck it, let's go. I'm going to the bathroom. I quickly threw on my shoes and walked out. It was raining and the sound and the feel was beautiful. Just a few steps in before the bathroom house and boom, there it was. Couldn't handle it anymore. I exploded with a painful, loud vomit over and over again. I gasped for air and looked up at the night sky. It was the prettiest shit I ever seen. I could see every raindrop as it came down to the earth as tiny white lights, and in the background the stars lit up and glowed and filled the night sky. If you've ever watched Riddick or the movie Pitch Black starring Vin Diesel, it was like a scene out of that when he takes off his goggles. Minus the aliens though. It was just beautiful glowing lights. I then purged about 2 or 3 more times and said, I've got it figured out. It was the aha moment for me. I figured it out. I always try to tough it out all the time and be the tough guy that can handle anything. I need to let go and receive help or ask for help when needed. Don't be ashamed to try or be discreet. Be willing to let go and not have to be the tough guy all the time. Back to the trip and post-purge. I entered the spirit world. The spirit world was like a vast land, black walls, black floor, black ceiling, but it was glossy with one single structure that stood in the middle. In the spirit world, first person I saw, my current teacher, Natasha, she was cheering me on for cutting ties and destroying my old beliefs and behaviors. I greeted her with a big hug, big laugh, and big cheers with my hands up like I just won a championship fight. And knowing that I've just seen her, I'm pretty sure my coach Norman was around. And sure enough, he was standing in the next entrance saying, Kendo! I walked up to him and hugged him. He said, it's Storm and Norman, Tower of Power. That man is such a funny character. I could only laugh. In the spirit world, it was good vibes, nothing to be angry about, nothing to fuss about. As I moved along, I realized that I was in the spirit world, so my biological dad had to be around. I then looked at this happening from a bird's eye view. It was my dad pushing through crowds to come and meet me. When we finally met, he hugged me and greeted me. We greeted each other. We were both happy to finally meet. And my dad got to see how big his son has got. I told my father that I felt like I let him down. I felt like I was in a lot of trouble and mistakes, and I've done things wrong, and I let him down. I said I wish he was here while I was growing up to guide me, with a situation of passing away he couldn't help. And I understand that. I said at least we got to meet here and now. And we had a laugh and we spoke about how much fun we would have. My time with my dad had come to an end. Until next time. So I hugged him farewell and I moved forward. I was able to apologize to previous relationships and wish them well as I moved on with my journey. I was also able to see my sons in the early stages of my trip. With the shapes and the colors, I saw a significant golden light appear in what seemed to be in the form of a throne. I couldn't figure it out why it was there or why it stood out so significantly, but the answer to my question lay within my two sons when I saw them. It was Caden and Kaysen. That golden throne in my life was Caden and Kaysen. In the spirit world, I got to see both of my sons, and they could both, well, my youngest son could speak clear as day. He's 3 years old. He can't speak that well, but in spirit world, he's speaking perfectly fine. My oldest son was there, 11 years old, and I was speaking with both of them. We hugged. I held my two boys close. The happiness and joy that I felt was great. It was a feeling of love like no other. They told me how much they loved me, and I could not stop laughing and playing and hugging them. And I had a great time with them, and I told them, my life is dedicated to making them the best that I can possibly make them, and show them the best way that I can show them, and allow them to grow the best that they can be, and be the best men that they can be. And then my trip wrapped up and came to an end.